Dear students, I'm going to start the fifth model. The name of the fifth model is Signals and Daemon Processes. Here two chapters are there. One is Signal, another is Daemon Processes. Let us see. So, first of all, in this video, the two topics we will study. One is Signals and another is Unix kernel support of Signals. So let us see what is signal. A signal is a notification sent to a process in order to notify it of an event that has occurred. It means, suppose a process is doing some work, but some urgent some urgent work need to be done by that particular process. So what it will do, signal, a kernel will send a notification to the process. So that process will leave its regular work and it will react to the notification. And this notification is called the signal. So for example, if a process is running and if we press Ctrl plus C, then a signal or interruption signal or kill signal will be sent to a process and the process will be killed. The signals are software interrupts. It is a software interrupts. It will just send a notification to interrupt the process. Signals provide a way of handling asynchronous events. Means a lot of events or processes are running, so they all are trying to run synchronously, now in asynchronous form. So a signal will be used to synchronize those processes or those events. A user at a terminal typing the interrupt key to stop a program or next program in a pipeline terminating prematurely. If a user press the terminating type, then it will send a notification or signal to kill that particular process or pipeline terminating prematurely. Means if a user will type the terminating key, then it will send a signal to a program to terminate it prematurely. What are the different name of the signal or type of the signals we have in the Unix operating system? One is SIG ABRT, means this is also called abort signal. So it will abnormal termination. It will terminate the process abnormally. SIG alarm means when the time has expired, then kernel will send a signal called SIG alarm to the process. SIG bus, it is a hardware fault. If any hardware has been crashed, then kernel will send a notification or signal to the process. SIG cancel, threads library internal use. SIG CHLD, change in status of child. This signal will change the status of child. SIG cont, continue stopped process. SIG game, SIGEMT, hardware fault. SIG FPE, arithmetic exception. Arithmetic exception occurs if any number divided by 0, this is an arithmetic exception. Then SIG hop, hang up. SIG ill, illegal instruction. SIG info, status requests for keyboard. SIG int, terminal interrupt character. SIG IO, asynchronous input output. SIG IOT, hardware fault. Like that only. SIG kill, termination. So like that only so many signals are there. we can use this signal in our program. Now few more things we have to study. When a signal is sent to a process, it is pending on the process to handle it. The process can react to pending signals in one of three ways. When the signal is sent to a process, if a signal is sent to a process, then these signals will be in the pending for the process. Now process will handle those signals. So the process can handle those signals in three ways. First way, it will accept the default action of signal, which for most signal will terminate the process. So first action will be there that the signal will terminate the process. This is also called the default action. Second point is ignore the signal. So process may ignore the signal. The signal will be discarded and it has no effect whatsoever on the recipient process. The signal will be discarded and has no effect on the process who has received the signal. And third is, the process may generate a user definition function that is also called signal handler function, and that signal handler will handle the or will catch the signal. So three action will be taken by a process if it receives a signal. First is process can be terminated, that is also called default action. Second action, process can discard the signal, no effect will happen on the signal, on the process. And third is, process can generate a signal handler function which will take care of the signal, or it will catch the signal. Next topic in this video, we are going to study the kernels of the Unix kernel support of signals. So see, when a signal is generated for a process, the kernel will set a corresponding signal flag in process table slot of the recipient process. As we know that every process has a process table. So when a kernel will send a signal to a process, then the flag, signal flag in the process table will be set. On receiving the signal by a process, the process table, the signal flag in process table will be set. Second point, if the recipient process is asleep, suppose the recipient process is sleeping, the kernel will awaken the process by scheduling it. So kernel can awake the process by rescheduling the signal. So when the recipient process runs, the kernel will check the process U area that contains an array of signal handling specification. When the process is in running state, then kernel will check the process U area, and that contains array of signal handling specification. Array of signal handling specification.